Hi, guys.
Hi. You guys, let's talk Real Housewives of Nairobi.
Yes.
If you haven't watched that show, I highly, highly recommend. I highly, highly suggest you go and watch it because it is what I think Real Housewives is supposed to be. Okay, let me give a brief summary of, you know, the housewives and how the show is, right?
Yeah.
You see money. That thing that we always hear of, oh, rich people. I was even shocked that Nairobi was like that. They have a lot of rich women.
People,
yes. And they have a celebrity amongst them, Vera Siddika or Vera.
Vera.
Yeah. Then they have some white people as well. It's like they have white people in Kenya like that. Okay,
yeah,
it's true, Sha.
So, yeah.
It's true. Remember when we passed there? I was trying to add that part, you know. We're passed there.
We didn't transit from Kenya. Yeah. But I actually want to go to Kenya.
Yes. Yeah. In fact, now when I was watching the show, I was like, I need to go to Kenya again.
And it's so close to Nigeria. It's a straight flight from Kenya Airways.
And it looks really nice. The place look nice. Even though I don't think it's
as... I think of just going there together, maybe. Just go and take a week off in Kenya. Then
instead of like doing group, I mean. Yeah, actually.
For somewhere else.
Yeah. Anyway, but the Real Housewives of Kenya, when it comes to drama, Nairobi.
Nairobi.
When it comes to drama, when it comes to shade, when it comes to direct to your face.
I love them for that.
Yeah.
There's no two-faced bitch over there. Okay?
Everybody says things to your face. Okay, so let's get into the cast. One is a doctor. Or was it? Is a doctor. She's a plastic surgeon, aesthetics doctor anyway. So all these injections and stuff so she does that one. Then they have Vera that is the
celeb. That is a celeb, I think.
Yeah. Then there's Sonal. Sonal is an Indian woman, but
she's just rich. What does she do again? I can't even remember.
She's
rich. Yeah. She calls herself the shoe queen.
Did you see closets?
Shoe closet, yeah.
Then who's next? There's one. Mine.
That one's just she's annoying. She's an actress.
She's just annoying. Then Vera is pregnant.
For her second child.
Second child, yes.
With her partner who has kids with other women as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then there's Lisa. Lisa is a white woman, but she says she has lived there for 20-something years.
Yeah.
She speaks their language very well. And she likes all this. She's actually those kind of white women that will say, carry Africa on their head. Everything about her is so African, so tribal, so, you know, she's like that.
Then there's Susan.
Susan looks like a South African to me.
Somehow. But actually, she talks so much like a Kenyan. She's very skinny.
She's a model.
Yeah, she's 40. She has grown kids.
Yeah.
She just went through a divorce.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one thing I love about this show. Let's start from I like the fact that nobody's hiding anything. First episode, we already know she's going through a divorce. Mm-hmm. She's happy about it. When somebody was trying to be, they're like, I'm good. You know, it was a long time coming.
Yeah.
And also, like, even the whole baby mama thing, even Vera, that's her name.
Yeah.
That is pregnant for her second child with her boyfriend. Mm-hmm. You know, why how she's open about the whole baby mama thing? Oh, he has kids with other ladies and stuff like that. Nobody's really trying to hide who they are.
I've always had this impression of Kenyan women before that they are very
open
and, you know, liberated like that. Like,
it's so nice to watch. It's so nice to see. And because it's not a big deal to them, it's not a big deal
to us. Exactly.
But Nigerians will kind of make a
big deal out of it. And I even like how Susan said that even though she's divorced, like, it was just amicable. There was no bad blood.
Yes.
They're just co-parenting.
Yes, normal. And they're co-parenting very well.
Yeah.
And even, what's her name?
Sonal.
Not even Sonal. The other one, Lisa.
Lisa
even later talks about, you know, how she was in a relationship before. She wanted kids.
Yeah.
You know, the guy had a vasectomy or something,
Yeah.
And then later got it corrected that she regrets not going because she doesn't even know what the full story is.
Yeah.
But later realized that he was shooting blanks. Straight up.
Yeah, you know? They're not
relatable stories. Mm-hmm. I love that about them.
Is it relatable?
Just
telling her stories.
Relatable now. Going through divorce. You know how many men are in the marriages and stuff, but they don't want to leave.
Exactly.
It's relatable stories. It's it's real.
And she's still popping. She's doing well. It's not like she's one sad woman in one corner. She's popping. She's doing well. She has money.
She's with her kids.
What does she do?
She has a makeup line.
She also has
a perfume. She's a reseller for a lot of big brands.
Yes.
She has a makeup line and a lot of other things that they mentioned, to be honest.
Yeah.
That's That's, those are the women of Real Housewives of Nairobi.
And they don't have as much drama as...
They do quarrel, don't they?
Yeah.
But it's, for me, it's meaningful quarrel.
It's meaningful. Yes, it's meaningful. And you can see them trying to form friendships like genuinely. Yes. Trying to bond genuinely. Their events are genuine. Like, nobody's coming with shade. That's not to explain it.
I get what I mean. Mm-hmm. And also, like, I like that they're from day one, you know what a lot of them do. Actress, musician, perfume, this makeup line. Lisa sells arts.
Yes, arts, even decor.
Yeah, all kind of things.
And then she does, there's this driving... This is driving thing that she does.
Yes, and then the doctor. So I like that from the get-go, you know what they do, right? It's something they were very vocal about. And also, I like that from the get-go, even the first event, it had to do with Susan trying to launch a new perfume line collection thing, something like that. Basically, it's not really a pointless...
Events, yes, exactly.
Over deco,
over, yeah.
Like, what's her name? The pregnant one, what's
Vera.
Vera, Vera's one was her baby shower. Yeah. You know, it was like meaningful events. I don't know how to put it
that makes sense. That's very relevant to the storyline.
Every event is almost like decorated by the same person, same vibe, the same thing. Every event is the same thing,
It looks weird.
Yeah,
but this one, like, everything is so and everything is unique to the person.
Yes,
it's almost like Lagos own show.
Because I remember Laura did her fashion show.
Fashion show,
What did Chama even do again? I can't remember.
Chama did dinner.
I don't know. Somebody did garden party. I think that was Caroline.
Yes,
you know, it wasn't even about being over the top. Is trying to be over. Let's just leave
Abuja. We're not here for them now. We made a video about Abuja. Go and watch it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, so the first event was the Susan's event. First of all, she came in with a chopper. I'm like,
do you understand? I'm like, she wanted a grand entrance. She changed like 4 times. She's like, this is what we're looking for. This is what we're looking for.
Yeah. And it didn't feel forced. It didn't feel like she's trying like her regular lifestyle,
you know. It was really nice.
And she wasn't even bitchy about it. Like, she wasn't saying, I'm coming there now to show all of them.
A lot,
like,
of them are
she
not likes, bitchy.
Yes.
There's no one bitchy person there. You would think the musician would be bitchy.
Yeah, but she's not.
I like the way she talks and she always laughs. It's like, she laughs.
Yeah, it's true.
She would talk and just laugh. She's always laughing. Like, she's actually one of my favorite, if not my favorite. Like, I like her vibe. She's very chilled.
Very
calm,
chill, normal.
Like, you know? Yeah. But for the perfume event, right, the doctor wasn't supposed to make it because she wasn't around.
Yeah.
But later, she surprised them.
Okay, yes, it's true.
She surprised them. And that doctor, I don't even remember her name, to be honest. I don't care. She's the only person with an attitude on that show so far. A bad attitude. Let me put it that way. And why I say it's bad, I feel like she feels better than most of those women because they're in the entertainment industry or something or such. She feels better. And you could tell. How can you come to an event and... Okay, they were talking about Vera. She made a post recently about removing her butt implant but apparently she doesn't even have a butt implant because people always telling her you have a butt implant. So she made a joke out of it. You guys telling her that's very immoral, that's this and that. Like, why are you taking it too serious?
Exactly.
And the way she was saying it, she kept bashing her
like she knew her personally.
You just saw a post on Instagram, and she has explained why she even did it. So
I think what happened there is that Vera had been doing so many, you know, class chasing things, basically.
Getting away with things.
So she felt like it's her time to come and, you know, put Vera in her place, that kind of thing. And I'm like, it's not your business. Nobody asked
you. I like how she's Vera. Like, you know what? You're just trying to chase the bag.
Yes. You know, and she was laughing and
she was saying,
you don't want competition. You don't want someone to come and spoil business for you. Yes. That's why. Yeah. But the other one took it more personally, Sha. The Mine. Mine took it too much.
Yeah,
it was almost like, and it's not even you that they attacked, but she took it on her head. Cried on her head.
No, because I feel like Mine is a people person. Like, she's the kind of person that I think normally will stand up for something wrong. Bad. Like, stand against something.
Something bad and then carry it on. Yeah, people like that, Sha.
Who do you find the most annoying on the show? For me, it's
Mine.
Mine.
Yeah, Mine is annoying, Sha.
She's very annoying.
She's always late.
She always has an attitude, and there's just something about her. Like, other ladies are getting along. I always tell people, when you're the one always not getting along, check yourself,
yeah.
It's not something to be proud of.
But, you know, from what the ladies were saying, they are saying that they feel like she's putting up an act. I think Vera said
it's possible.
And it's possible because when they now start bashing her, she now starts acting like, but what did I do? Yeah. Like she starts feeling like a victim somehow.
Yeah.
But she's the one that comes with attitude, the way she does her face. Say she has resting bitch face, but I'm like, no, it's more than that. I really don't.
I actually feel like she feels less than.
Okay? Yes, yes.
Because somebody insulted her with, not insulted, well, they were pointing out, oh, you're not on my level. Mm.
She brought it up first, though. She brought it up first.
Every time she would not talk, she like, eh, should we have thrown? I'm here.
Yes.
Like, mm-hmm. I don't know how to explain it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I feel like it's
yeah, and she's always trying to overcompensate for it,
yes,
by coming late and always
wearing,
you know, one thing in her mind. She's all kind of people that don't really have money, but they think this is what people that have money wear.
Yes.
So she will now wear over the
see top that one outfits. That she came very late. She said, My stylist. We're like, you had your outfits.
Yes.
You know, I don't get the stylist thing.
I don't get
like it. If I'm to have a stylist, right? Mm-hmm. You're planning my outfit before that day. I don't need you to get ready.
Yes.
I
want
to come and just zip my clothes.
Zip my exactly. What are you?
She's like, my stylist. So the person, they were like, you already had the dress. Mm-hmm. The stylist picked out the dress. They already had. Why couldn't you just dress up mm-hmm. on your own?
Yeah, exactly.
She was, is it 5 hours late?
Seven hours late. Yeah.
Who comes for something 7 hours late?
And she was even
late.
Saying that, you know, she even said that she lost her father-in-law. That's why she came in.
Full glam.
When I say full glam, I mean full glam to the max.
It's not like you were crying.
Mm-hmm.
It's that you were doing hair and makeup.
So there's no excuse for that. But, okay, let's talk about the other ladies. Lisa's personality is just
there.
She's just there. She's
Lisa
just,
is
okay.
The comfort of their show, but better.
But better, yes. Comfort like, better. Yeah, but better. Because I remember when she hosted them in that, there's this driving thing she does. She now brought one kind of cheap hotel for them. The women did not like it, the women did not like it, and it looks very cheap. It looks like cheap. All these very cheap Nigerian hotels.
Yeah.
Stuff.
Mm-hmm. They were like, do you know that? Like, were you? Me, I won't even stay in the hotel.
Uh-huh.
I don't like the hotel. And I've never been as rich as this woman.
As in, one person left.
She needs to go home. good for her.
Mm-hmm. Then Susan. Susan is okay.
I like Susan. Mm-hmm. I like Susan. I like she's opinionated, but not too much, not too loud.
Mm-hmm.
She has her own personality that shows and shines through.
Mm-hmm.
She speaks up. She's just, I like her as a person. Mm-hmm.
And even though she has money and she likes nice things, she just admits it normally. She's not doing it as, I'm rich at that. Yeah, she just, I like nice things. Oh, like she wants the whole experience. She's always saying it, you know, so...
I like that. I love her fashion as well.
Yes. Even her diary session, like
her outfits,
her hair.
I even took a picture of one or two of her outfits. Mm-hmm. I'm like, no, I don't know how, but I need this outfit.
Yeah.
I need this outfit.
Her hair is always on point. And she does like over the top
hair.
She's
a model,
but still,
she's used to the spotlight, she's used to the whole thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, she's one of my favorites. Mm-hmm. But I think my absolute favorite is
Vera.
Yeah. Not because she's been doing too much, because she's just laughing
just normal,
at me herself, and you mm-hmm. know, I like Vera. I like Susan as well. I like Minnie as well, right? But she's not up there.
She's not up there.
I feel like she doesn't really bring a lot when it comes to character.
Yeah.
Personality. When it comes to personality,
she doesn't bring
a lot. She's always somewhere in the background.
Mm-hmm.
Even for the fight, there's a part they were insulting her. She was like, "Can we chest to that?"
Okay, that you mean Son Now.
Son Now, sorry, Son Now is not one of my I don't love her.
Yeah,
like she doesn't bring a lot when it comes to personality.
Mm-hmm.
She's just always in the background, and that part
always in between.
When Minnie was trying to talk to him, she was like, "Can we chest?
Can we chest to that?" Yeah, and she quickly she went to try and address Minnie's.
Yeah,
you know, attitude. When Minnie changed it for her, she now drew back.
Mm-hmm. Speak up for yourself, and you don't have to fight. She was trying, can we chest to that? Minnie said, it's alright, can we chest to that? Imagine you raising your glass, trying to chest to somebody.
Somebody's just trying to, and you are still trying. I think you're one of those people that are people pleasers somehow.
She is, definitely.
And I think
she just wants everyone to be happy.
To be happy and just
love at all times. For her, that's what's good.
As
long as, okay, if I don't share this opinion, everybody will be happy.
Happy,
fine.
Let me not share it. Yeah.
I can swallow it. I can be angry inside.
But
let everybody be happy.
Yeah. No.
That's her. She doesn't, for me, she doesn't bring a lot to the show. Hopefully, she has not done her event or anything. So hopefully later, I feel
She did though. She's not the one that did the cluttering. Maybe it's not event,
yeah.
The cluttering.
I hope that's not the event. Because that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
No character. Do you understand? No character,
Nothing,
nothing really.
And she's very pretty, good
fine.
Body as well.
Mm-hmm. All in all, the ladies of Nairobi, they're actually nice, relatable.
Yeah,
they're rich, but you can still relate to them.
To them, yeah.
and they are all individually different.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the doctor quit the show because she couldn't take
the heat.
Meanwhile, Naha bring the heat.
Now she but
you brought the heat. They tried to give it back to you. Mm-hmm. Oh, even talk about that part that after she brought the heat to Vera, wanted to go apologize in person.
In person to Vera
for a dinner.
Mm-hmm. And Vera was like, Vera don't even give her time. Vera don't even give her
like. Like you insult me in public.
Public, yeah.
You want to apologize in private.
She was trying to tell Vera to just listen. To just listen. Vera said no.
Goodbye. She just stood up and
threatened. I said walking away.
I'm like, Abuja people don't get the mind. They don't
see.
I love that babe.
She stood up and left. And then that one she still walked after her, was trying to even stop outside. She didn't answer her. She just walked away like.
Because public insult where everybody is
yes
you want to put another woman down
like, you know,
for no reason
it was so unnecessary
anything to you personally and I don't I used to say
yes
no remember I say you cannot apologize
you come out to everybody
you come down that place where you caused that disease you gave me this up you come and apologize. You know, all these people calling me to their office job apologize there let all your workers too
see you apologize.
Yeah, I don't like that thing though because people don't know how it ended. You can go and talk shit later
even
say it's me that begged
that begged thank you, as if that was kind of what she said, she wanted us to make peace
you that place you caused that embarrassment you apologize for it there. So I love that she did that. I love it. It's so me. Don't apologize to me in private though. After I give you public embarrassment. Don't do that. But yeah, the ladies are actually very different.
It's very different
from Abuja, Lagos, Nigeria, generally speaking. Obviously, it's not supposed to be the same.
Yeah, but to me, they are more real, funny enough. I can relate to them more than...
Even they are richer.
Yes, they are richer. But seriously, they are actually richer. But yeah, the women are just nice and relatable. So I like it. I like the fact that they show their wealth.
Yeah.
And, you know, they know how to really host.
Yeah.
They know how to invite. They know how to host. They know how... They have that high society life kind of thing. So I really like it.
And I like that they have personal stories that they are sharing. Mm-hmm. That making people even relate with them more or understand them more.
Yeah,
I like that nobody's trying to hide or form. I'm always happy. I'm always nice. What you see is what you get.
I don't have issues.
Like everybody's bringing it real on that show, and that's what makes the show special to me.
Yeah,
it's just real. Okay, but you guys, have you watched it?
Yeah, let's know. I think they have because people were telling us to go and watch it. So we finally watched. I finally watched it.
Yeah, I watched it finally. For me, well, you guys, let us know what you think about Real Housewives of Nairobi.
If you guys are going to invite us, please invite us.
Please, Real Housewives of Nairobi. Come on, invite us.
I'm telling you.
I don't know.
But seriously, when I watched it, I was like,
I like them. I really want to go there.
Anyway.
Yeah.
So now watch the video we did on Abuja.
Yeah.
If you've not watched it already.
Yeah.
And we'll see you in our next video.
Bye. Bye.